was a friend of mine that started this White Gay Power. It was, I think, because I had people that worked for me, and then, you know, I had very serious views about things, and if you do something, the way I would talk to you, I'll tell you as it is. So, I think when we'll be sitting down and this thing, he says, when he will hear my opinions on a lot of things, he just say, White Gay Power. So that is how he said it was something that said in my sister's room, my late sister's room, White Gay Power. Before I knew it, shrine people had carried it. This was the old shrine before my father died. That's before I knew it, it had reached the new shrine. And before I knew that, everybody calls me White Gay Power. So it just, I guess it was a name that was going to stick. YK dollar, YK pounds, YK euro. I don't know why they called me that, because I don't have money. But they always calling me all that, you know. I think from YK power, all those other, okay, I remember Thatcher, Iron Lady came out. That was because when we first started the shine, I really put my foot down on a lot of things. Let me see, what other one? Those are the ones I can remember.
Thank you.
It was just, I took it in my stride, really. I didn't think I deserved the name, but if you call me White Gay Power, I think it was amongst friends. It was a friend that gave me the name. So it was, my sister's name was Sola. He gave my sister solar energy, you know. So it just,
okay.
We just took it amongst ourselves. It was just, it surprised me was when the name escalated. And even to now, because this name, this was before my father died, like 93, 94, that I got this name. Which is now that in 2015, people still call me White Gay Power. That's a surprising. When they offered for to host the show came, I was happy because my friend and I had already been talking about having a talk show together. Mm-hmm. And so I immediately jumped up. I didn't even question it. I said yes, I will do it. The only thing that I can say is I've not made money since I've done the show. I thought that if I do the show, my money will come, but no money has come. That's what. But we have impacted a lot of people's lives, and that is very, and I think in a positive way. So that is a good thing. A lot of people, a lot of ladies especially, even men, come up to you and say, thank you for your opinion that day, thank you for this, I love watching the show. So that we are in the lives of a lot of people, is a very positive thing. The only thing is good money.
Mm.
I wish money was
by the side.
My personal life affecting the way I read. The way I am is the way I am. I don't have airs and graces. If I meet people outside, I try to be as nice as I possibly can. Sometimes if you're in a bad mood, it's a bit difficult. But then nobody knows your mood. So I think being negative, because I remember once, many years ago, I met a celebrity. And she was, you know, I was at my daughter's school, and she was there, and I said hello to her. She just looked at me. She didn't even look at my face. She didn't even answer. And I felt really bad. And I promised myself I would never do that to anybody. So I will never consciously be rude to anybody. Because I think it's, no matter who or what you are, be nice. It's very, you don't know who you're going to meet in the future or where you're going to meet anybody. So I think it's very important. So anybody I meet, I try my, so if I've met you and I'm not nice, Joe, forgive me, because I try my possible best to be nice. Because I can never forget was because I now met her again many years later after I had become a celebrity. And she was nice to me. And I thought, oh, at that time, because I was not a celebrity, you were not nice to me. That means you're not a nice person. Same person. Okay. I'm the same person. In fact, I'm even trying to change because somebody abused me the other day that they're the only one that doesn't speak Fone on the show. So I want to change. I want to start speaking Fone, you know, because everybody else on the show will say, oh, oh, and now we say, come now. So I want to say, come and go and speaking properly now. So I think that's, I try to be myself, but it's affecting my reputation. If they do, I tell them immediately, there and then. I don't wait till after the show. Nima, come, go. It's not like that. So I mean, the show is a very natural show. And everybody is as natural as they possibly can be, considering that you're on TV. So I don't get upset. I know we have post-production meetings, so if we have any problem, we say, this is the problem I had with you on the show. But for me, they all respect me very much on this. I appreciate that. I really, really do appreciate that. Shrine, I run my father's estate, I run the house, I run my life. I'm quite busy, Charlie. I haven't danced for like 3 months since celebration. I've been 2 weeks. I start again in January. I've been mentally weak actually to start dance class, but I do have my dance classes. I only have one child.
Okay.
So only one child. She studied computer science, so she's a computer analyst in London. Okay. So, but my brother's son, Made, he's at the Trinity College in England, and so I'm not a musician. He's a musician. So hopefully he will run the shine when my brother and I are gone.
Okay.
Ask me that question is very difficult because that's the only person I've ever been. I've always only been the last daughter. I've not been your father's daughter. I've only been my own father's daughter, you know. So life has been the only life I've known all my life. I guess being the last daughter, though, has its ups and downs. More ups right now than downs, because growing up a lot of people didn't want to associate with my father because he was fighting government, because he was smoking a blow, because he was doing this, you know, or he liked women. So a lot of people liked to don't want to be their friend though. But now everyone wants to be your friend, which is a good thing, you know. But I learned from my father to be very humble. Humility is like for him, it was like the key of life. So his children have just taken that, you know. I think that's the biggest lesson I've learned. And then to be African, to be a proud, not just be African, be a proud African, be proud of your color, be very proud of who you are as an African, not a Nigerian, an African. We'll be right back. here, enjoy, eat well, don't eat too much, you, because you'll be on the road to size 10 if you eat too much. Like me, of you people, we're all on the road to size 10. Have a wonderful holiday, and I wish we all go into 2016 together in a good way.